Hello everybody, I'm installing a Tremec TKX 5-speed transmission, and I've been having a hard time trying to get the right clutch information, flywheel. It's been interesting. I did talk to Silver Sport and a couple other people. I had my own bellhousing, and I wanted to use the original one, and I was trying to get specs on their clutch, the throttle bearing, closed, and it was kind of hard getting that information, and how far the fingers set up and set in. It was really hard, and I've been calling around, talking to a lot of other people, and the only people who really work with me was Speedway Motors, Ram, and Quartermaster clutches. And this is just some of the parts here, and I had quite a few more. And I will show you pictures because I got rid of some of that stuff. But I got everything worked out, and I actually wound up using a Ram clutch and disc and a Speedway Motors 7/8 flywheel. And I had a lot of room to spare with washers and stuff. This really worked out well. And the pressure plate is actually, if I remember right, it's still, I'm trying to remember, 2,800 pounds of pressure, if I remember right. Might be a little bit more. And let me walk on over here. I'm gonna show you. And this is the spacing I have. This is the bearing retainer. So I have quite a bit of room there. And that room is actually 0.38. So I got a lot of playroom with a few washers and stuff now. And I'm using basically a stock bellhousing on that. And this right here is what I paid for everything. And that includes the bellhousing. Let me make this a little bit clearer. And let me see here. The throwout bearing was actually a Speedway bearing. I read online and a lot of people was happy using it. And that was actually, if I remember right, 1.710 closed. And that's the price of the flywheel, the Ram pressure plate. And that's the master cylinder and the bellhousing, because this bellhousing is actually open at the bottom and I had to use one. And that's my transmission mount right there. And you can see what I used. And that was the total. And I'm gonna show you this again, so you can see exactly how much space that was I have now using the Ram pressure plate. And I had a few other pressure plates in here. And some of the specs wasn't quite right. And I'll show you the master cylinder. And the master cylinder is right back there. Boy, I had to pull all this stuff out. You can actually see what I'm working with. It's a Plymouth Earl pickup truck. I'll go ahead and show you some pictures inside. And, oops, let me see the flashlight. Light don't want to work. Uh-oh. There you go. Boy, what a lot of work. Yeah, I definitely had to cut it. Plymouth Earl's pickup truck is really tight. I had a TH400 in here, and I just didn't want to redo the cam or anything like that. And I had a 4500 stall converter, and that was just getting too hot. And actually, I'll do a quick little walk around. And I actually have two gas tanks, 116, and oops. I got two fuel pumps too as well. Gee, kind of hard doing this. And I have via switches where I can mix both of the gases into the carburetor. The carburetor is a 1050 CFM. I did have a roll cage in it and a roll bar and wheelie bars on it. And I took all that stuff out. It's going to be a street truck now. This is an all-motor truck. and we'll go over to the transmission. And you can see it was easy for me to just pull that off. It made things a lot easier for me to measure everything up by having it off. And actually, I'm gonna stick this in there so you can physically see what I'm talking about. And you can see I put the screws on the back. All right, I'm gonna get up on it. I'm gonna try to do this with one hand. And you can see those fingers are way up in there. Boy, it makes things a lot easier. Let me pull this out. Oh, make sure this thing slides real easy in and out. You know, and you just want this real in and out of there. Makes that transmission go in there. I should have felt right up in there. Let me see if I can do it. Hope there's enough light up under here. Bear with me. All right, this makes it a lot easier. Let's just stick this in there. See, like that. And I guess I'm gonna need some light so you can see. Oh boy. Where's the flashlight? Where did I put that flashlight? Uh-oh. Oh, sorry, I don't know where I put the flashlight. Well, let me take this light. And that's actually pressing right up on the fingers. So you can see. And I'm gonna show you some pictures of what I used and kind of like what I went through. It was really hard trying to get, you know, this information. And I did talk to quite a few different clutch people too as well. And Silver Sport, they wanted to sell me a whole kit with the bellhousing and a double clutch disc, and I really didn't want that. I just wanted a single in here and use my stock bellhousing, which this right here is actually a stock bellhousing. It's set up just for it. So my exhaust could run through here on both sides. Matter of fact, I'll show you. I have a remote or a filter too. But this worked out pretty good this way. I've been messing around with this for 6 months, just trying to get information, and a little misinformation been out there too as well. But I'm gonna make sure everybody have everything I use, and y'all can go from there and maybe mix match, and maybe save yourselves some money too by going this route as well. But everything is basically set here. Okay, now let me get out. Come under here. Oh, boy. I don't know where I put that flashlight. I had the flashlight in my hand. Oh, there it is. Oops, I'm going to walk back over and grab a flashlight. Sorry for this. I don't want to redo this over. So, just bear with me. Let me show you some inside on this side as well, too. And I even put a woofer in here. Probably won't be able to hear it though. And this is my stick shift. I actually made it. Uh-oh, there's my light. Doesn't want to stay on. But anyway, that's my stick shift. Right there. God, I wish I could get that light to stay on. Let me see if I can just pick it up where you can see it a little bit better. There you go. Pretty cool. And you can see in here. Boy, what a lot of work just getting this in there. Oh, let me walk over to where the pictures are. Zero back in on the transmission. And I had to make my own. Oh, let me show you the mount I made. I'll go ahead and post it. I did have it painted, but it got kind of scratched up because I had to pull it out so many times. Oops. And this is the mount I made. Oh man, I got it all scratched up and dirty. I had to pull this thing out so many times and install it. Whew, I ain't gonna paint it no more. Oh man, just trying to get this thing set up right. What a trip. Oh, you can see what I'm working on. I'm gonna put a bed over this too, eventually, and put a wing on the back of it. About 6 inches high. It has a little cut in it as well. Put a wing on the back of it. Okay. And I'm gonna walk over here. I did took pictures of some of the other stuff. If I can get it back. All right, let me see now. Let me blow these pictures up. Okay. You can see how the bearings was pressing in, and that's a 1.710. I do have some bearings 1.5 something too as well. Too, but it was pressing way in. And I bought all this stuff 2 years ago, and I was told that this clutch setup will work. With, you know, with a Chevy 350 type motor. And this is a two-piece. All right, let me go to the next picture. And you can see, oh, okay, 1.7025 is the bearing I'm using in there now. I actually have a few bearings. Yeah, make sure you get that. And you can see I had two more pressure plates that you probably won't even, that I don't have pictures of. And you can see how high the fingers were on that particular one before you press in. Now, when you go bolt it down, the fingers do go in. And it was hard to get that information. So that's why I was buying a few different other flywheels. And this flywheel here is actually 1¼ inches thick. And I tried a 1-inch and a 7/8. The 7/8 worked best for me. I would probably go that route. It'd make things a lot easier. And you can make up the difference with these washers right here. I hope this helped people out. Don't go through what I went through. And this is one of the other pressure plates right here that I tried. Now, all the fingers had different heights. And when you tighten down on it, there was different heights. It wouldn't quite make it work. Let me see. You can see that. You can see. That's the clutch disc that I use, and that's a Ram clutch disc. Ram was really great on working with me and helping me get this straightened out. Quartermaster was too, but Ram had really what I need, you know, but Quartermaster was great. They kind of put me on the right track, and then Ram kind of like kicked in, and you can see the flywheel. You can see the difference between the flywheel and how much room that gave me. And I shaved the bolts down so it would clear the clutch disc. And there's some other pictures of a lot of the stuff. And this is the Ram pressure plate that came in, and that's model number. Let me make sure everybody gets this. Where's the pressure plate? Is Ram 401C, and that's what I paid for it. Oh man, what a nightmare. I am over the hump now. I am so happy. Yeah, 41C. You can actually see it. Oh, well, you can see I took a picture of it. You can see the spacing. And the fingers are, the hydraulic bearing is actually pressing. Not pressing, but it's touching the fingers. And I have plenty of room. And you can see this one right here, fingers were 2.8 tall versus one of the other ones was 2.5. It was a 2.6. And once you close it down, the fingers do go in once you tighten it down as well. And they all had different measurements. And that's the picture of the bellhousing that I'm using. I needed the bottom open so to help clear the exhaust. And I run a 2.5-inch exhaust. I did have three inches before, but 2.5, and I had changed the cam on the exhaust side a little bit more duration, a little bit more lift to compensate for it. Let me see if they'll have any more pictures. And that's a stock bearing. And you can see, you know, how tall that is. If I was running a mechanical or manual clutch. Okay, let me see. And you can see that, actually, that's another one. You can see the, can you make that out? Yeah, you can see that one is 2.55. So the RAM will work, and that's all the pictures I have. I hope this really helps some people out. I'm gonna post it on YouTube, and I'm gonna go back over the pricing. And that's the motor mount. I'm sorry, correction. That's the transmission mount that I use. You don't have to go chasing that down. And that's the bellhousing I use for my application. A stock bellhousing would be fine, because that is a stock bellhousing. It came out just right. And so I hope this helped people out. And let me see down here. And this is the space that I need to clear, 1.5 to 0.25, but I'm gonna do 1.8 and call it a day. The actual gap is 1/8. They said if I got this would be the minimum on that. But RAM followed through. I can't think of, I believe the guy's name was Mike, and he really went the extra mile with me and worked with me. Nobody went that extra mile with me the way he did. And I'm so glad. I'm actually going to buy another pressure plate and keep it as a spare. And I'm going to buy another disc, a little different than the one I bought. And I might buy one like I have too, just to keep them as a spare. But I really appreciate what RAM did for me. I mean, I was almost hopeless trying to get this straightened out. And Tremec, they really couldn't help me. You know, they kept sending me to Silver Sport. And I did talk to McLeod, and it just didn't work out for me. You know, that's all I got to say. You know, not hating on them or anything like that. It just wasn't working out. You know, but this is everything right here. And I hope this helps somebody out there who's getting into this. I went online and looked at a lot of different people installing, and it was hard getting this kind of information. And just remember, the flywheel thickness, that plays a role into it. I would just go ahead and get a 7/8 thick flywheel, that RAM clutch, pressure plate, and you know you'll have it and it won't be no issue. Now, with that flywheel being 7/8, you might get away with running a flywheel, a pressure plate, that's 2.5. That might get you right above 1/8. I tried that too, but I wanted a little bit more room as well. So I just hope this helps somebody out. And shout out to Ram Mike. Man, definitely saved me, and I'm going to get my Plymouth Earl pickup truck back up on the road. Thanks to this guy. He really went the extra mile and gave me specs of everything I needed. And he said, I'm going to work with you. And I'm a RAM believer. I ain't gonna stray. So I hope this helped people out. Thanks for looking. Happy motorists to everybody out there. I just hope nobody don't go through what I went through. It was a very unusual experience trying to get information. I wanted to kind of pick and choose what I wanted, instead of just spending a lot of extra money on a kit, or with some kind of keep telling you what you recommend. All right, take care. Thanks a lot.